For almost half a century, the Honda Civic has been a go-to car for compact car buyers, but this redesigned 2022 Honda Civic might be able to sway a lot of mid-size buyers too. In this review, we're gonna take a full detailed look at this new redesigned exterior, the new modern interior, and get it out on the road and see just how well this car drives. And this is the touring model, the top-end Civic. We're gonna talk exclusively about this, but I have another video where I talk about what's on the different trim levels if you wanna see that in the description below. Hey, real quick, thank you for tuning in. My name is Nolan. I do full reviews like this every single week. So if you wanna see more videos like this, be sure to subscribe down below, but let's get started. All right, let's start out by looking at all of these exterior details. And this is completely redesigned. Front end, sides, everything on the exterior is redesigned. And this is the top end touring model, but we're still just a little under $30,000. So I'd like to hear your thoughts on the price point. But up front, you'll notice you don't have that chrome bar anymore. It's very wide. These headlights are extremely wide set, and it's just a low front end. It kind of reminds me of the Accord in a way with how low and wide it looks. But you have this daytime running light, which is LED, running up above the headlight, and it's really bright on the side. And you've got LED high and low beam reflector headlights right there, plus an LED fog light. It's nice to see that Honda also gives us an LED turn signal. And what do you think of this front end design? But if you want to see more about these headlights and how well they do at night, I have a night video describing exactly that and taking it out on the road so you can get a good idea of how good they are. Find that video in the description below. This paint color is called Lunar Silver Metallic. It's got a nice little metallic-y sheen to it. It looks good with this Civic. Honda actually gives you quite a few different colors. But as we branch out, take a look at this design from the front to back. It's very low. Honda said they wanted thin and light design and almost has a bit of a fastback design coming to the back. Leave your thoughts down below. The wheels on this Civic Touring are gonna be 18 inches. So there's another type of 18-inch wheel that you can get, but these are the standard 18-inch wheels with those shark gray inserts. Those wheels are pretty sharp and the tires on there are 235 40 series tires. To see the mirror also gets this LED turn signal. That is just on the touring model. There's also a blind spot indicator in there. There's no automatic dimming or tilting or anything like that. Dimensionally, the Civic is just a tad bit longer than it was before, but it still sits in the compact class. And it's a little bit bigger than some other compacts, but it's really spacious inside, all things considered, just how big it is. And Honda actually improved the structure of this car to make it a bit more rigid, to give it better driving dynamics. And we'll talk about that in the test drive. The taillights are gonna be LED, so you've got a totally different taillight design. I like this taillight design much more than the previous generation taillight design, but you see you still got a standard incandescent bulb there. No special spoiler here, but you can get one if you want to. And the exhaust is totally concealed, but there's a little trim piece down here. The Accord Touring gives you a little more flashy rear end, but this is still nice and modern. Now, cargo space in a small car usually isn't great, but it's actually really good. And check it out, with the touchpad under there, all you do is press that or use your key fob or the button inside and it will lift all the way up by itself. It's basically like a power trunk. There's no hands-free option, but it's still good enough. And the opening here is really large. I mean, you can fit a lot of stuff through just this opening. Sometimes that's one of the problematic factors with small cars, but this is great. And there's a lot of space on the side. There's a lot of space back there. It's really deep and wide. There's about 14.5 cubic feet. Plus, you can fold the seats down in a 60-40 fashion. My only complaint is that you'll see, like, on the sides, there's no hooks for grocery bags or a cargo net or anything like that. A lot of times, in most cars, they have a hook or something where you can sling some grocery bags so they don't roll all over the place, but not in the Civic. And under here, of course, you get a spare tire standard, which is great news. And when you're all finished, you don't have to touch the dirty trunk. You can use this little handle to close it. Now for Honda's Smart Key, the Smart Key system is standard. The key fob's a little bit different. It's almost a little bit more rounded, but you've got remote start on here, standard on this touring model. So the Smart Key system works like this. There's a few little lines right here that you can lock it. The mirrors will flash, or there's a sensor in the back to unlock it, and then you're good to go. And there's two more things I wanna show you. First of all, if you have the key with you and you shut the door, like you're getting out, maybe you have your hands full of stuff, you shut the door, and once you walk away, even just a few feet, boom, the car automatically locks. You can turn that walk away auto lock feature on or off if you want, but I've found it to be really handy. I just always turn around to make sure the car actually locks, but also press the unlock button and then press the unlock button again and hold it, and watch this. The sunroof and all the windows can open up. So if you're a ways away and your key fob can reach, but your car's really hot and you don't want to remote start it, you just do that and it'll let all that hot air out. But what would be really cool is if you could do the same thing with the lock button and roll the windows back up, because now I gotta roll them all back up. Time to look at this front seat. So this is actually a brand new seat design. So the last generation Civic seat, if you didn't like that one, maybe you'll like this one. If you love that one, maybe you won't like this one. But this touring model is leather wrapped. So you've got leather up here, leather here, even perforated leather coming down, and then some decent bolstering on the side body and some decent bolstering on the bottom. There's some nice shaped bucket seats. And then down here we have a tilt adjustment. You got forward and backwards, up and down, and then you've got your reclining, but there is no lumbar support at all. No adjustable, manual, or power lumbar support. That's a big bummer. Now Honda, I understand this is a compact car, but a lot of other cars give you adjustable lumbar support. And it doesn't matter what size of a car you're driving, everybody has different needs. So lumbar support should be added. These seats are heated on our touring model, but there's no ventilated seats and no memory settings. You'll find ventilated seats on some other cars this class, but not in this one. And overall comfort is still good, even though there's not the adjustable lumbar support. I mean, it's not completely hollowed out, but it's not as good as you'll find in a lot of vehicles. But overall, aside from that, room is good. Comfort is good, the bolstering is good. I like these seats for the most part. And the steering wheel is leather wrapped, and it's a really nice soft leather. This actually feels really good. And you've got a little bit of sport grip up there. It's not too thick, it's not too thin. And then the steering wheel is tilt and telescoping, so you can move it in and out and up and down. And there's a pretty good range of motion. There's just no heated steering wheel. I wish that we had a heated steering wheel, because that's another feature that you'll find on some competitors. And then one other new feature is that Honda actually gave you new front airbags designed to reduce head and neck injuries. So they've always had airbags, obviously, but they updated their airbags for better safety ratings. And then in the back seat, there's one extra thing that I think you should know, but wait till the end. There's a little bit more hip and knee room and shoulder room, so there's a little bit more space. And the back seat is really spacious overall for a car this small. One quick note, this upper material on the door is a cheap plastic. That's pretty common in these vehicles, but you've got a soft padded armrest for your passenger and a really large bottle holder. And legroom sitting behind myself is pretty good. My knee space is really good. My foot space isn't great, but it's definitely good enough, especially for this class of a vehicle. Got no complaints with that. Right in the middle, you won't find any air conditioning vents directly, but you've got a couple of USB charging ports, so you'll have to rely on those for air conditioning. There are heater ducts underneath of our seat, but you gotta rely on the front for air conditioning. There is a hump in the middle, so middle passengers might not be quite as comfortable, but there's also this center folding armrest with a couple of small cup holders and some padding. And then headroom is good enough for me to sit here at 5'9". I can feel my hair touching a little bit, but otherwise I can sit up just fine. And these seats are not too bad at all for a small car. But here's one thing, this touring trim level on the last generation would give you heated outboard seats. You don't get that in this one, at least not in the US. Maybe in Canada, but we don't get heated rear seats anymore. That's a bummer. But check this out. One feature that Honda added is a rear side airbag for the back seat. So you've always had the curtain airbags, but you have a rear body side torso airbag for backseat passengers, which is awesome. And check this out. My car seat fits with that seat even to where I like to sit. So I can actually put the car seat behind me, which is not always the case, even in some larger vehicles and crossovers too. That's fantastic. The inside of the Civic is completely different than it has been, especially a couple generations ago. It's got a new modern design with a more high-tech, human-centered interior, but it's still simple and, of course, practical. So first things first, let's go ahead and start it up. Push button start. Right back there, you've got a fully digital display there and a large digital display there. And like you saw, the modernized interior space. So real quick, over on the door, you get a soft material up here. If you like to rest your elbow up there, you're good to go with that. Soft down here and a nice good size padded armrest, good grab handle. Both the front windows are automatic one touch and just those ones. My bottle does fit down there. It's a little pain in the butt to get it in there, but once it's there, we're good. And then good storage right here. So first of all, right in front of us, check out this fully digital display. You change everything using your steering wheel. You can customize what's on this left side and what's on the right side. I'll go through those in a second, but you use the left side of the steering wheel to do this. You can even get rid of your audio or your clock. So if I get rid of that, it simplifies it. So you just have a basic tachometer, and then you can decide, you can even customize which of these things here are even available to see. So you can get rid of some of these options if you want to as well. And then on the right side, it's the same thing. You've got a trip computer, compass, you can have safety or like a driver attention level monitor, seat belts, oil life, all your safety stuff. You can customize with that too. And you can customize this as well. So check this out. We have it on the round setting. You can go to bar to where it's just like, it's totally different on both the left and the right, the tachometer and the speedometer. Or you can have it be a more minimalistic type to where it's just pretty simple. And once you start driving, it'll simplify the way everything looks. And for those of you worried about materials, there is a semi-soft material coming across the dash right there, and then a little bit of plastic trim pieces here. But right here up on top of the dash, you've got a 9-inch touchscreen. So this is gonna look very similar to what you see in some other Honda products as far as the actual software. You have an actual physical home button, back button, volume knob, tuning knob, or not tuning knob, but seeking buttons right there. And then you can even customize these little shortcuts on the bottom. So for example, let's say that I wanted to put my phone, you can drag it just like you do on your phone. So you can have these shortcuts customizable down here. But you also have wireless Apple CarPlay and wireless Android Auto on this touring model. So I have a plug right there, but I do not have my phone plugged in. Got my phone right here, so that's awesome. And you also have wireless charging, so you can have it wirelessly charge and have Apple CarPlay running, so you don't have to worry about plugging anything in. And the nice thing is it takes up a good part of the screen, so that looks nice, and you can quickly get back to your home screen. There's a little bit of customizable stuff on here. This is not my favorite system, but it definitely works. And sitting on top of the dash, there is some glare, as you can see on it right now. There's really no coverage for it at all. And for the first time ever, guess what? We have the Bose sound system in here. We have a premium audio. It's a 12-speaker Bose sound system with a subwoofer. So, and this also does sound pretty good. I've got a little audio clip. Let's go ahead and take a listen. Now, I took a recording with binaural audio, so go ahead and plug your headphones in and we can take a listen to this Bose sound system. While we're up here, let's go ahead and turn into reverse. So you've got the same backup camera where you've got three different angles and rear cross traffic alert as well. Plus, these are dynamic guidance lines. Now these air conditioning vents are really interesting. It's like a honeycomb style. And do you hear this? They actually make little clicks. There's actually some like feedback from them. But this is an entire section right here. And there's a blank space, and then it opens up over there again for your passenger. But we have dual zone climate control, so you and your passenger can still have your own controls. You can have them synced up, completely independent. But I love the fact that we have dual zone even in a small car, easy to operate, and these have some nice clicks to them too. These actually feel pretty solid. I really like what they did with that. Three-tier heated seats on each side. Wish there was ventilated seats. Then you've got a couple of charging ports and a 12-volt power outlet. Plus, if you don't have wireless charging, you can have this as just a little storage area. But there's a little bit of ambient light that shines down in there as well. Then coming back, we've got a traditional shifter here. We've got really good-sized bottle holders. One of them sits down a little lower than the other one. And check it out. You've got drive modes, auto stop start, electronic parking brake, and even a brake hold button. And I'm really glad this isn't all piano black. This has a texture to it, so it's not going to show lint and scratches nearly as easily as piano black. But if we go through the drive modes, first of all, we're in normal. Then we go to economy mode. It'll actually kind of make this a little bit green. Or you can go to sport and it'll turn things red. We'll go through the drive modes in the test drive. The center armrest is not adjustable forward or up and down, but it's in a pretty good spot to where you can have your arm on there and be able to hold the wheel if you want to. This is padded. It's actually wider than a lot of people would probably expect. You've got a little storage tray right there that is removable. And for this small of a car, it's pretty darn spacious. It doesn't have the multiple functions like the other generation Civic, but it's still nice and spacious. Honda's glove box is not lockable and it's pretty small. But overhead, you get an automatic dimming rear view mirror. Plus you've got all LED interior lighting here. We've got a sunglass holder. And then we have just a standard size sunroof. There's no panoramic roof option in the Civic. As for the visors, it's always good to see those will also slide straight out. And just a quick look at visibility, these front pillars are pretty small. Going out the back, you have a fastback type of design to where it kind of almost is like SUV-esque back here. The back windows are good size, but it's not great in that back pillar. And one other quick note, you can probably see those little lights up there. Those are little ambient lights. So you've got one here, one there that shine down on your center console at night to give you just a little faint ambient light, which is just enough to help. Now under the hood for 2022, there are two options, but on the touring model, there's just one option. And for 2022, it's got a little more power and it's a little bit more efficient. You get Honda's direct injected 1.5 liter four-cylinder turbo engine with 180 horsepower and 177 pound-feet of torque paired with the CVT transmission. Before you knock the CVT transmission, let's go for a test drive first in just a bit and we'll get on it and see how it does and talk about that. But there's no manual transmission option for the sedan right now. Efficiency is also improved on this Touring with 31 miles per gallon city, 38 miles per gallon highway, and 34 combined. That's a bump of 1 mile per gallon in the city and combined. All right, let's get on the road in this Honda Civic. Before we get started, if you're curious about the driver assistance features, Honda Sensing is standard, which is a full suite of a bunch of driver assist stuff like automatic emergency braking, the lane keeping system, radar cruise control, etc. We also have blind spot indicators in our mirror, automatic high beams, but let's go ahead and get out on the road. And with this point of view drive, I want you to get an idea of what it's like to be the one behind the wheel. Now, if you've never driven a Honda Civic before, they're very easy to drive, they handle well, they're super nimble cars, and they're somewhat fun considering the class that they're in. Most compact cars don't really have a fun factor, but the Civic can, especially with this turbo. It's really quite peppy, and some of you are gonna just completely not even consider it because it has a CVT, but this is better than you'd expect. And if it's reliable, and if you do maintenance with this CVT, it should be reliable, then there shouldn't really be a problem with it. We're just in normal drive mode right now, and it does have the auto stop start system. It's pretty aggressive, but it takes a minute to get started again too. So it's kind of an annoying auto stop start system. But acceleration is good. We'll get on it more and do sport mode in a little bit. But the handling, I think, is probably one of my favorite things about the Civic. Not just the actual handling dynamics of the car, but the way that the steering feels. It's not, you know, as sporty as some, like, but it's not super stiff, but it's not really tight and lightweight either. It's got a good amount of feedback to it. And Honda actually retuned the steering for this year, so it's supposed to feel a little bit different and a little bit better. And passing power, just a little bit of pedal. The turbo kicks in and gives you power pretty darn quick. And the transmission has been really responsive. I've actually been really pleased with this CVT compared to other CVTs that I've driven. And it's driving itself right now. We've got the lane keeping system, the lane centering on. You can turn that off or on with the button on the steering wheel. But in fact, I'm gonna see if it does it right here. It is. Even though we don't really have good lane markers, it did it right there. I don't have a full demo of it with this Civic, but other cars I do. But anyways, with a turbocharged engine, you get a quick amount of power and boost pretty early. So the RPMs don't have to go way up high in order to give you power. For example, a little bit of pedal. RPMs are still low, but you get good power right away. And braking with the Civic, it felt a little bit soft initially, but I think it's actually a little bit more touchy and a little more firm than some people might expect. But I'm gonna put it in sport mode. Should be a little bit more fun and hold the RPMs, and we'll see what this CVT actually feels like and sounds like.
right away, it's actually holding the RPMs a little bit higher, just going slow. But at a rolling start, I'm gonna go pedal down. Here we go. And it still has that CVT drone where you don't get the traditional shifts, but it somewhat mimics them. And it's holding RPMs up. It handles very well. It's nice and flat around the corners. And good pull coming out of the corner. It's responsive. So the CVT is very quick to respond. You don't have to wait as long as the traditional automatic for it to downshift and then go. It's pretty much ready to go. Now let's see if it can take this corner. Nope. And I don't want you to act like that and drive like that, but I just wanted to see if it could do it. But anyways, the handling of the Civic is good. Now, as far as ride comfort is also good. I wouldn't say it's as good as the handling and the way the steering feels, but considering a small sedan, the ride comfort is good enough. It's a pretty average for the class, I would say. You get an independent suspension in the back, so that should give you a better mix of ride and handling, which it does seem to do. On the day-to-day basis of driving this, that screen does get some glare on it sometimes, and I get glare across this black plastic trim piece. Like right now, it's just really bright. It doesn't happen all the time, but in certain situations, it's just angled up enough, kind of right into your face, that can be annoying. But I like the cubbies, I like the storage, the dual zone climate, all the controls. The front digital cluster is easy to see. I like the soft material up here to rest your arm. It's a comfortable car to be in, and most people should have no trouble feeling right at home in this Civic. Now we're back in normal mode. Let me give you a good run, and then I'll tell you something I don't like. So we got up to speed. Now something I don't like is the road noise. Now Honda actually said they improved the road noise. And when you're not on a bad textured road like this, it's actually pretty good. It's not bad at all. But once you get on a rougher texture like this, the road noise is more than I would like and more than some competitors like the recent Hyundai Elantra and Mazda 3. Those are both quieter than this. And Honda has the ability to compete with them, but they're just not. I wish this was a little bit quieter, but another thing is I've noticed a little rattle from this screen. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't, and all I have to do is put my hand on it and it stops. So that's a little concerning. Also, a rattle from the seatbelt buckle, that's pretty common actually. Put a little tape on it and it'll hold it still, but I'm a little worried about this rattle from here because this is all like plastic around this and it just sits there with really not a lot of structural support. So I don't know, hopefully yours doesn't have it. The one I drove from a dealership did not, but otherwise, driving this is very nice. Leave your thoughts down below, but let's go ahead and get our closing thoughts.
Now, closing thoughts on this 2022 Honda Civic. As always, it's practical, it's efficient, it's big enough to fit families, but a smaller and more affordable car than the Honda Accord. I feel like Honda did a good job. I don't feel like they did anything revolutionary or anything crazy, except the design is definitely a lot different than it used to be. But feature set wise, it's still very similar to what it has been, and that's a good thing. There are always ways that you can improve, and that's no different with this Honda Civic. Like the lumbar support, there's no adjustable lumbar support. That should be on any car, especially a top trim level car like this. But compared to other compacts, it's very well rounded, it drives well, it's efficient, it's really spacious. It just doesn't have quite as many of those top features like you might see on, for example, a Hyundai Elantra. But this car, even though it's not as big on the outside as a midsize car, it's probably big enough on the inside and drives well enough to take midsize buyers away and look at this Honda Civic. But overall, it's a better car than it was before, and I'd love to hear your thoughts down below on what you think of this new Honda Civic. But thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It really helps me out. Subscribe for more reviews every week, and be sure to check out the night review of this Honda Civic too. Have a great day.